Hello everyone. Today, I, Divija, welcome you on behalf of TechTable. TechTable is an edge tech startup by students of IIT Madras, which aims at connecting engineers to opportunities. As they construct a bridge between students and startups, they match the portfolio requirements of the companies with the skill sets of the students, thus making the internship fruitful for both. So for this special session, please join me in welcoming Sai Krishna, who just got an admit in IIM Ahmedabad. So hi, Krishna.
Hi, Divija. Thanks for the introduction.
Yeah, sure. So without any further ado, let's get into the interview. So my first question would be, can you tell all of us about yourself, like your education background?
Okay, so my name is Sai Krishna Kota. So I was born and brought up in a place close to Visakhapatnam of Andhra Pradesh. So I had done both my schooling and plus two with Narayana Group. Then as along with most of the people, I gave JEE mains and advanced and got an opportunity to join IIT Madras in civil engineering department. So my BTech is in civil engineering at IIT Madras. So at IIT Madras, I tried to be as diverse as possible, worked with many teams in the institute, made many friends. So it was a great 4 years, which is coming to an end in a couple of days. So that's a brief introduction about me.
Okay, that's great. So when did MBA come into the picture? Like, when did you choose to do MBA?
Okay, so the thing is, as you know, in third year internships start coming. I mean, as a curriculum part, we need to sit for internships and give tests. So as you know, coding plays an important role in getting an intern or placement. Somehow I never had an interest towards or inclination towards coding. So I thought getting a job or getting an internship in the campus itself is difficult. And I am also very less inclined towards core domain. I did not have really much interest in all the subjects. So even the core option was to be ruled out. So when I explored further options, I had to do an MBA or I had to go for some government job. So I felt looking at the CAT syllabus and thing, I felt since I'm an engineer, doing math part would be an easy task. So I thought, okay, chalo, let's give an attempt since we are still in our final year and I'm not sitting for placements. So that's how I started my journey with CAT.
So did you anytime think of, you know, going abroad for studies, like for MBA?
No, I mean, I never had an option of going for abroad because when I found out with my seniors and several people whom I know, it's like you need a good amount of work experience, say at least 2 to 3 years when you wanted to plan for an MBA in foreign. So it's like I immediately ruled out that option. So I had decided to give CAT and go into IIMs itself.
Okay, that's great. And so you were in your final year while you were taking the CAT exam. So how did you manage preparing for both CAT and for
yes.
final year?
So I mean, as you know, in seventh semester, we beat people generally sit for placements. So most of my friends opted for placements. Along with them, even I had tried to maintain I tried to opt for several PEACE courses. Since it was online, I mean, we came home due to pandemic. So most of the things were turned online. So I just opted 6 courses from the curriculum. Since it was online, even professors did not stress us too much. And even the courses were relatively chill, I would say. So that's how I got time to manage my CAT. Before starting of the semester, I tried to complete the concepts and made myself sure that I don't require much time during the semester except for giving mockly and weekly tests. So that's how I planned my semester and managed both of them.
So how many months did you prepare?
So I would say, let me give a rough timeline. So I started my prep in mid of the June, right after completing my internship. So I almost took 45 to 60 days to complete all basic concepts, to understand the exam, to find out what exactly the exam requires. I tried to check several previous year papers, understand the pattern. So it took me almost 2 months. So then I started giving mock tests. So September and October is full of completely giving mock tests. It's like giving 3 days a mock. I almost gave around 50 mocks. I used to give mocks, tried to analyze them. I spoke with my coaching institute mentors. And in the November end, we had the CAT exam. So it's basically almost 5 to 6 months prep.
So you said a coaching institute, right? So which institute was that?
So I joined IMS Adyar, which is closed institute. So I took only test series subscription. I felt that I don't need classroom teaching again. And since it is online, I felt if we have any doubts, we can look it up on YouTube, or there are many free resources which are available. So I felt taking test series would be more than enough. So I just opted for IMS test series.
So when you opt for test series, they can you also ask them your doubts?
Yeah, I mean, so each IMS center will have around three mentors. So you can always reach out to any of them after a mock test. For example, let's say I give my mock on Sunday, and after 3 or 4 days, detailed scores and video solutions will be released. So initially, I'll have to work on my video solutions, work on my mistakes, try to analyze what I did wrong. So if I find something difficult, or I did not understand, or I want to find how to do things in a very short time, so I used to contact mentors. For example, in VARC section, initially I had a lot of trouble. I wasn't able to find out answers easily. So I spoke with mentors, because they'll have a lot of experience. They'll be dealing with these, I mean, with students of our type for almost 10 to 15 years. So when I spoke with them, they guided me with their experience. So it helped me a lot, actually.
Yeah, that's really good. So would you mind sharing your, you know, like a rough preparation schedule, like for all the three subtopics for CAT exam?
So after checking through the syllabus and giving initial couple of mock tests, I understood that quant is my strong, I mean, quant is my strength, and VRC is my weakness, and DILR, it can either make my exam or break my exam. So I am sure that I need to work upon my VRC and DILR, ensuring that my quant doesn't go very less. So I used to spend every day 1 hour just to read editorials of the Hindu and Indian Express, because I felt newspapers are a source where you get a lot of different articles from various domains. For example, it may be polity, it may be history, it may be philosophy, it may be sports. So you get in different type of articles at a single place. So I ensure that I read upon newspapers. So once I'm thorough and familiarized with different domains, I started working on my RCs, so reading comprehensions. I tried to look upon some free resources such as WordPundit website, or free resources shared at Unacademy Telegram channel. So I used to practice them regularly. I used to spend some 90 to 120 minutes every day to practice RCs. So I would say you won't see the results instantaneously. You need to trust yourself, because it's a long journey. I gradually started to improve in getting good scores in VRC, but I wasn't really confident enough till the end exam. So I used to practice it consistently. And for DILR, what I had done is, so I used to try out different thing in every exam. So for example, in one mock test, I started with attempting DI sets alone. So in the next exam, I started to attempt LR sets alone. So it's like I tried various things. I found out at which part of DI or LR which I am good at. So I found out that I am comfortable in doing certain type of sets. So I used to improve in my weakness. So this is how I had done my preparation.
So Did you also prepare for QA? You said you were comparatively better at QA.
Since I was better at QA, I did not have a necessity to spend in building those concepts again, because I am basically good at math since my childhood. So I just had to revise the concepts which I studied in my 11th and 12th and basic schooling. So once I am thorough with concepts, I understood that I just need to improve my speed to increase the score, because that will pull my score to a good total. So initially I used to solve some 15 problems per an hour. So I used to put a timer and made an attempt till I should reach 30 per an hour. So I guess by October I used to solve some 25 to 28 problems per hour. So ultimately I just worked on my speed and accuracy in quant.
Okay, that's great. So your basic source was the mock tests, right? Like writing them helped you realize where you were weak, and you worked on them like for more amount of time.
Yes. So the reason which I just believed in these mock tests is, so basically they'll be curated to a greater extent, and they'll be similar to the CAT examination difficulty level. For example, if you take a textbook, there will be problems of easier type, difficult type, moderate type. So you need to put a lot of investment to find out a good number of problems. Whereas if you take mock tests of this year or PDFs of previous year mock tests, it's an already curated content. You don't need to invest your time in finding whether the test is good enough or not. And the other advantage is you can take it in an exam. So it will be a timed practice. So I just took the PDFs of previous year papers and I just solved it at a stretch for 3 hours. So it was really helpful.
And so you are supposed to give a written ability test also, right? So before going to the interview. So how was your experience with that?
Okay, so the thing is, since this time the interviews were shifted to online, only I am Ahmedabad conducted the written ability test. It's called analytical writing test, AWT. So there used to be Telegram preparation groups for each institute. So IMA interviews were started in the month of February, first week, and my interview was scheduled in March 30. So it is almost last phase of the interviews. So every day people used to post their interview experiences and AWT topics in the Telegram group. So for the initial couple of days, and I just used to look at the topics. I just used to frame my answer and structure it. So when I felt comfortable, I mean, I used to practice, it's like 7 to 8 AWT topics. So at certain point, I felt that, okay, I could easily structure my answer properly. Given that I had a good familiarization with the topic and I know enough content. So then I just did not worry about my structure, and I just kept on reading the content, because AWT topics can vary a lot. It may be related to current affairs, or it may be related to recent events, or it may be some general philosophical quotations or statements. So it all depends on your luck and question given on that day.
And how was your experience with the interview? Like, were you asked, what kind of questions were you asked?
So I would say my interview experiences were pretty mixed, actually. So starting with my first interview was with IIM Kozhikode. So I was really clueless, because it was my first interview. I did not have any prior experience. And 5 minutes to the interview, I was cut abrupt shortly by the panelist. He started shouting at me. And at the end, he told, it's like, I just really worried by the statement. He just said to me on the face that, your answers are pretty much bullshit, and you don't appear to be an IIT graduate. I don't know how you are going to get graduated. It struck very deep to me, because I did not expect such a bad interview. I also felt that they did not give me an opportunity to pitch myself, and they weren't really listening properly. So I mean, maybe it's not my day. So I thought, okay, IIM Kozhikode anyway is not my target. I am just aiming for IIM Ahmedabad or Calcutta. So I just started to pick up myself and I started to prepare current affairs again. And my IIM Lucknow was my next interview. So it was mostly revolved around basic current affairs and why MBA questions. So I thought this would be a practice for my IIM Cal and IIM A interviews. And so next was my IIM Cal interview. So in IIM Cal interview, it's like I really did not expect that the panel would come up with such a question. So in IIM Cal, we'll be asked to fill up an application form. It's common with every IIM. So before the interview, they'll send out a detailed form. We need to fill out the details. So in IIM Cal, I just filled my 10th and 12th as Narayana Group. So I done my schooling and college with Narayana Group. I filled the same. So the interview panelist somehow looked at it. So he started right away asking this question. So you're from Andhra Pradesh. You studied almost 4+2, 6 years with the Narayana Group. So is there anything left which they did not take away from you? I mean, they took all your 6 years. They took the creativity out of you. They took your sports and other interests. So why do you think we should give an admission? So it was really unexpected from their side. So I just tried to convince myself. They kept up on grilling. It's like you Narayana students don't have any real interest. You just follow the crowd. You wasted an opportunity at IITM. So you are not going to your core field. You are going to MBA. So justify yourself. So it went on almost for 5 to 10 minutes. And later, even the second question was also really unexpected. So I thought they would ask why I would like to do an MBA, but they asked me, why do you want to join IIM Calcutta? So I was like, sir, it is the best institute. It has good culture. The panelist replied that every interview student would give the same answer. I want something different. So I was like, I was just stating some ranks and other achievements of IIM Cal. He just seemed to be satisfied. So the next, he asked me a couple of maths questions. So I just solved them and answered them right away. And later he asked some current affairs. So since I was preparing well, I just answered them. I thought it was pretty decent, but in the initial part, he did not seem to be convinced, but that is subjectable. As you know, the opinion might vary from different person to person. So I just gave my best. And my last interview was with IIM Ahmedabad. The one of the best interview, which I would say, because it's like, it's a almost a half an hour duration interview. They touched upon almost all the aspects, ranging from my UG academics, why I wanted to do an MBA, current affairs, even my UG courses. So it's like a overall decent interview.
So for IIM Ahmedabad, so they are, so was there any question that you couldn't answer?
Yes, actually. So the thing is, they started to ask right from my UG. So the panelist asked me, which UG course do you like most? So I said, sir, I like concrete technology. So he asked me why, and I started explaining why I like it. So the point I told, sir, there is a good amount of research going on in making buildings earthquake resistant. So he asked me, why do we need making buildings earthquake resistant? Sir, I told it's the problem which is being faced by many years. So engineers are trying to come up with new methods. So they are trying to do variations in the reinforcement, etc. So he asked me, is that only the method? Aren't there any other methods? So I gave the names of other methods. Then he started asking me, so what are the disadvantages in those methods, which is being led to, I put a lot of effort in research and development of new concretes. I was like, sorry, sir, I don't know. And there are certain couple of questions which I did not answer. For example, so they asked me about the alumni of IMA. I gave them a couple of names, Chatan Bhagat, Ishika Sharma, etc. So the panelists asked, Ishika Sharma still the CEO of Axis Bank? So actually she was not, but I told, yes, ma'am, she is currently the CEO. I mean, I told just with my confidence. When I came out of the interview room, I found out it was wrong. That's okay. I mean, they expect us not to know everything because we are learners and we'll make mistakes. But whatever you say, you should just present yourself with confidence. But whenever they're trying to point yourself as wrong, you should be ready to accept your mistake and change your stance. Because you shouldn't be blunt and overconfident about yourself. That's what I felt, actually.
Okay, that's good advice. So I'll just ask like sort of a summing up question that let's say like what strategy would you give for the coming students, like for the aspiring students to prepare? Like, would you like advise them any strategy for preparation?
Yeah, sure. So the first thing I would say is never see your CAT exam preparation and interview preparation as two different things. The day you decide you prepare for CAT, you should also ensure that you are preparing right from day one, that you prepare for both CAT exam and PI together. I mean, I would say it is an integrated preparation. Never see it as a different things, because you can't build a good profile in a couple of weeks or couple of months. You need good number of months to prove that you are a worthy candidate for MBA, and you should show the interview panelists why you are willing to do an MBA, and till that point of your life, what you had done to move forward in that particular path. See, for example, I wanted to do an MBA. I had decided that in my BTech first year. So I should spend my BTech second, third, fourth years to do something related to MBA. It may be courses, or it may be some PORs which give me management skills, or it may be some marketing or operation interns. I should build a good profile. That's what my first suggestion. And my other suggestion would be, this is a long journey. You need to improve yourself every day. See, you can't stay at a single point and expect to reach the final destination. So you should just keep track on your performance. There might be lows and ups in every journey. It's common, because you may not be getting good scores in every mock. There may be mocks which you get a very low percentile. So you need to pick up yourself. So this is my other advice.
Yeah. Okay, so I just wanted to ask, you mentioned that to build your profile, you should do something related to MBA and your BTech. So what did you do?
To be honest, since I decided CAT was my exam which I should give in my seventh semester, I did not have much time to build a good profile. But I would say for the people who are aspiring, at least in the institute itself, there are several courses. For example, if you take, you have F4, Fundamentals of Operations Research, or Marketing Management. Just give me a minute. Yeah. So you have F4, Marketing Management. Financial economics. There are very good courses which will give you a broad idea. And the other thing is, I would suggest you can pursue some online certified courses such as CFA or Green Sigma, Six Belt. So there are many good online certified courses, or you can even look upon doing some online internships related to marketing or operations or finance. Or at least I would say try to develop some good hobbies, because there are many people who just answered the interview questions just by mentioning their hobbies. For example, I have known a person who just mentioned his hobbies as reading. So the interview panelists were very interested in his reading hobby, and they continued to ask questions on the hobby itself for almost 15 minutes of his interview. So I would say just at least build good amount of hobbies.
That's a very good and different kind of advice. And so let's say there's the student who wants to write CAT, and let's say that that person still needs to improve on all the three sections. So what sort of schedule would you advise for that person?
I understood the question. Since the person is not really good at all the three, I would suggest to find out which section he could improve his score the most, because CAT is an exam which you don't need to be your peak performer at all the three sections. And I don't expect all the aspirants to be good at all the three, because it's really impossible. I have seen people getting very decent percentiles just by pulling up their scores in either one or two sections. So I would initially suggest try to find out which section you are good at, or which section will give you high rate of return when you invest certain amount of time. For example, for me, if I spend 1 hour on QA, it will give me high return because I'm very good at it. If I spend the same 1 hour at VARC, I might not get the same amount of return. So I would suggest find out the thing, and at the same time, ensure that you're crossing the minimum percentile required for all the sections. So even though you're getting some 99 percentile in both DILR and QA, and you are unable to qualify in other VARC, it would be useless. So ensure that you are decent enough in all the three, and you should be strong in at least two or one sections, so that you get a decent percentile. And I would say spending at least 90 minutes per each section a day would be ideally enough, because it's a long journey.
So writing an exam doesn't always depend on the preparation. It also depends on the day you write the exam, right? So would you suggest any like sort of strategy for taking the exam?
Yeah, absolutely. The point, I mean, I would agree with the point, because see, I mean, even luck has a factor to play a role. I mean, I did not believe in luck until I gave this exam. So for example, I would suggest you to stop preparing about CAT or just before a week of the exam. I mean, be in your high performance mode until a week before the CAT. But once the CAT is approaching, I would say just keep all the things aside and start relaxing, because you should not be worried about your percentile or how would you attempt in the examination day. So I would say keep your mind very calm and free. Just go and give the exam without any second thoughts. I mean, you should never worry about failure or what would happen after the CAT.
So also by
writing, that would be my advice actually.
Yeah. So while writing the exam, do you suggest like any sort of section they should start with first and then go on to the other section, or it's completely based on them?
I mean, it's a decided. You need to follow the same order which the examination gives. So first VARC, okay, and then DILR, then QA.
Okay, so the questions.
Okay. So since I would say most of the engineers are might not be good at VARC and good at quant, but the order of the exam is such a way that VARC comes first and QA comes at the end. So I would say don't stress yourself or become completely tired in the first section itself. So even the selection of questions matters a lot in the examination. So try to pick up easy questions in the couple of minutes and build your confidence. So once your confidence was built, you can work upon those lines and increase your score. For example, in let us take DILR. So there will be some almost 6 to 8 sets. So you need to find at least two sets which you can solve in the first 10 to 15 minutes of the exam. So once you are able to solve those couple of sets, it would obviously boost your confidence to a very high level. So then even the complex sets, I would say you might be able to crack in a good amount of time. So selection of the question matters a lot. And the one more important advice which I would give is treat all the three different sections as independent. So even if you aren't really performing very good in VARC section, your CAT exam isn't completed. You still have other two sections which can pull up your overall score. So if you're not good, if you did not perform in VARC according to your expectations, I would say before the timer ends for the VARC section, forget what happened in the VARC section. Start completely new in the next section. So treat each section as a different entity so that you could achieve good amount of scores in all the three.
Okay, great. Can you just give us two ways you prepared, like the sources, like what sources did you refer to prepare for the three different sections? Like maybe two important sources for each.
So coming to ARC, I just relied on free resources. So the Word Pundit is a very good website which I found. So they'll have daily practice reading comprehensions. They'll post good articles daily to read. Even they used to post verbal ability questions every day. So I found it as a very good place because it is a routine. They try to build as a routine. So it's like almost 120 days plan. So you need to religiously follow it from day one. It helps you to make VRC as an integral part of your life. So that is one of the website I found very good. And the second source which I would suggest is Solving RC 500 by IMS or RC 99 by G-Man Club. So that's a good amount of RCs at a single place. If someone is really bad at RCs, you can look upon and you can solve. And the third thing is obviously mock tests of any institute. It would obviously help you to fine-tune your exam strategy. And coming to DILR, the one source which I suggest is the Elites Grid YouTube channel. So it's a free resource. They have good compilation of DILR sets every year. So for example, if you take previous year, they almost posted 200 different DILR sets. So that's a huge compilation for an aspirant. 200 sets in place, you can practice 10 sets per day for almost 20 days. And that would touch upon all your basic models. And if you still feel you need a certain amount of sets, then you can look upon Unacademy's free resources. They'll be posting regular DILR sets in Telegram channel or Facebook groups. That's for DILR. And for QA, I completely relied on Arun Sharma textbook. So I just completed all the concepts from Arun Sharma textbook. I solved level one problems. And I solved level two from certain chapters, which I wasn't confident. So once you're done with that, you'll be most probably touching upon all the sort of problems that might come up in exam. From there, you need to work upon your speed and accuracy, try to reduce your mistakes of calculation, reading the questions properly. So it's ultimately you need to play by the rules and pull your score as up you can.
That's the like really good resourceful information. And okay, so one thing that I would like to ask is, do you think that having a job experience, like if you have a job experience, you'll be like considered more over the other students in the interviews?
Yeah, I mean, this is one of the frequent questions which CAT aspirants want an answer for. Because even before I started to think of exam, I also felt that should I really have a work experience? But let me make it clear right now that work experiences can be, I mean, it comes with an added advantage. It is not mandatory that you need to be a work experienced person, because each IIM will have at least 30 to 35% of freshers in their batch and 25 to 30% of work experience. So if you come as a fresher, you will be preferred for certain types of roles in placements. For example, freshers are preferred for marketing roles, general management roles, etc. And work ex people are preferred for certain types of roles such as product management. And work ex people will have an advantage in the lateral placements. So I would say each set of people will have their own advantage. If you are giving it as a fresher, it's fine. If you are coming with a work ex, even that's fine. So there are not any significant disadvantages for people of both categories.
Okay. So I guess that's all I had to ask. Do you want to give any concluding message?
So I mean, my concluding message is I would say just believe in yourself, give the exam certain amount of respect. And ideally, the amount of hard work which you put really matters. But the CAT examination isn't the complete life, because there are many factors. I mean, the final B-School admission is a culmination of many different factors. All the factors aren't in your hands. Just try to work upon the things which you can improve. Don't worry about the things which aren't in your hand. That's what I would say.
Okay. Great then. So I guess that's it. So thank you for watching. So bye everyone.